An arthroscopy is a specific procedure in which you make limited incisions, frequently 3 up to 5 incisions, and this can be on most frequently the knee and the shoulder. Techniques now are being developed for hip arthroscopy. There are certain techniques that are for ankle arthroscopy and also for wrist arthroscopy. The most frequent surgeries seen in orthopedics is arthroscopy of the shoulder and arthroscopy of the knee. I'd like to discuss those at this time. Usually the patient has failed the conservative care. And at this point, the quality of life is compromised, and upon shared decision-making with the patient, we proceed into a surgical intervention after the failure of non-operative treatment. The arthroscopy itself is performed by making small incisions approximately 1/4 inch in length and inserting a camera about the size of a ballpoint pen. This particular camera is inserted into the joint, and then this is transmitted through fiber optics into a high-definition TV, such as a flat screen or something you have in your house. By working the camera throughout the joint, we have made very minimal incisions and we can see the maximum as far as the joint is concerned. At which time, the evaluation of the actual joint itself is similar to such as when you take your vehicle to Jiffy Lube. They have a 15-point check and they go through and see, making sure that the normal is normal and the abnormal is corrected. We perform the similar thing as when we perform arthroscopy. We look in the knee and shoulders and we look at all the particular articular surfaces, meaning the cartilage. We look at the meniscus. We look at the cruciate ligaments, the ACL and the PCL. We're also looking at the lining of the joint, and we're looking at as to whether the mechanics of how the actual joint functions is present. When we look in a shoulder, we're looking specifically again at the cartilage and specifically at the rotator cuff. And there's a small tissue that gives stability in the shoulder called the labrum. Frequently, this is injured. In both cases, techniques have been developed and including equipment that you can go into another small hole and insert sutures, suture material, specific screws, specific anchors, and go in and tie or fix and repair torn tissue such as the meniscus or the rotator cuff. This leaves a very small incision, therefore minimal tissue damage throughout the shoulder or the knee joint, and enables the patient to get back to faster recovery.